One, two. Oops. Accidentally opened Opera. Hello everybody, and welcome to the Creden's Crypt live stream. I'm Pete, one of the artists for Creden's Crypt, and today I'm going to be working on animating this guy here, which I've just called him a fish man for now. He's just kind of like a comical looking fish creature. And I thought I'd stick a face on him that was kind of on one side. Fish kind of typically have that. Some do anyway. but yeah, he just kind of like paces around. But I'm thinking of a way to have him swimming. I'm just going to be working on his walk cycles for today. Oh, that's Skype. I'm gonna close Skype. Okay. I'm just gonna make sure I'm coming through. Sam, can you hear me? Just let me know in the chat if I'm coming through okay and that. Okay. So, I'm going to get started. So, I've already made a start today with the walk cycle, and it's just a simple four frames. And I'm just going to be taking fits from this, which is, it's all the directions you would need. Bare from the face, because the face isn't even a realized, so I'll just have to draw the face in when I need to, but it should be enough to use quite a bit from, so I'm gonna make a start with the next the next direction. I'm gonna start sideways, do all the extreme directions first. This is what I do. I just copy the frames. Start a new symbol. Paste them back in. Drag them into the scene. So we've got the beginnings there. I think that skeleton's there. Just I always take a skeleton and use that as a comparative, really, because that's kind of the average. It's kind of like the human size in this game. So I wanted this guy to be a little bigger, just a little clunkier. And I always think if something's a bit bigger and bulkier, it's more primitive. So that's why I've gone with that. And so I'm just gonna work on doing the extreme points now. So this is just the trident, which I'll probably. I think I'm going to hide that for now and just start on. Alright, so I'm going to just start by drawing the hand here. In fact, I will get his head at this point as well. Should be fine for the arms. I don't think the fishman would be a good walker. He would probably be a good swimmer, which I do want to work on, but I'm not quite sure I'm going to do that yet, so he's just going to be a pretty rigid looking walker. Right, so I'm going to do a more straight version of that. Yeah, Sam's just told me I'm coming through okay, so happy days. I should, eventually I'll stop doing these tests and I just want to make sure, you know. Don't want to be wasting all that energy. So, I've got a nice leg there. Let's stick that in. Straighten it out a bit. That's probably too. Actually, I'll get away with that. Yeah, like I said, it's just going to be a simple 4 frames for each direction. He's got just kind of a walk going on, really. So he's not going to be looking too fast. Like he won't be moving too fast, I'd imagine, on the ground. He isn't a land creature after all. With walk cycles, it's, you know, doing the basic walk cycle, you can, the more realistic you do it, the more sort of twisting of the ligaments you do. Like even the feet, the hands and the feet, there's a lot of character in that. But for something simple, I think you can just, you know, you can experiment with the way that you walk. I mean, it's always the same. There's always these four extremes, and you want to just make sure that that it's showing that. I'll just use a bit of a mix between traditional and puppet style. Really, that's the most economical way of doing it without it looking obviously puppet like. It does offer a bit of both, really. You can have it quite fluid but keep it economical at the same time. the way I like to do it anyway. Okay, so we've got one extreme there, twisting his head quite a bit there. So we'd probably just bring that back down to, he'd probably come, I think I'm going to move this foot more forward here. Probably do a more curved version of that. It's like these middle points coming back to, they're pretty much in the middle, but you can you can sort of vary them slightly and it does look good. It's like you can do, I mean, if you really wanted to be like super economical about your walk cycles, you can just have this frame as the same on both sides. So he's just that foot coming there, and then it would be coming back down. I suppose this frame here, this leg can be used. Just in the background there. Because that's the one that's going to be flicking off here. Yeah, still a little too much really on the extreme point. Okay. Oh, he's flicking that out. Oh. So I'll just play with it till it looks. You just always gotta be scanning back and forth to just see how it connects. That's looking alright. And then you'd have another frame here. I'm gonna just take this frame. See, that looks flipped. No, that's going to be too much, that. Okay. So, I'll just check. So, you want it about there. Okay, that's not too bad. Just want it to curve a bit more, because it's going to be the, it's going to be coming back. And this is because of just the way it twists. It'll fall short on a touch, though. It won't be quite the same as this side, where that goes all the way straight. It looks straight side on there. That one wouldn't be. It'd be more front facing. So you bear that in mind. And it'll look right with how it twists. It's just a similar way to how I did this knight that's on YouTube actually. It's called Many Faces. It's like a time lapse video I did, just animating it. And that was just pretty much twisting, just keeping that in mind. And it ended up looking quick. Like pretty good. And I think it's a good way to give something character that has a simple shape. And you know, you're just making use of those frames that you've for your idols and things like that more. You just makes it more interesting, I think. Okay. As you can see, that now is it looks right there, but it's just this one here that I've not done yet. And that would just not be much different. It would just, again, be foreshortened. Actually, go inside that. Just a slight. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, I'm not always going to be talking through things because it does take. I do have to think a lot about what I'm doing, and it takes away the concentration. You know, it's still. I'm. Like, when it comes to actually drawing and just being creative, it's like. It's not that hard to really think about pausing something once. Because, you know, you plan the. You just plan a like a generally plan like an armature out of like or a wireframe. You know, you roughly draw something out, and you're literally just spending most of the time on the actual details of the object. Whereas with animation, you're just constantly thinking about how something should look, and you're always having to check it all the time. And just keep going back to other frames. And it doesn't always look right when you actually hit enter and see it as well. It looks like he's just throwing his leg a bit too much there, like he's kicking a tree. That looks like he's just like, ah, like a TIE fighter fish. So yeah, I want to change that so it's more. He's got more twist in it. Oh, yeah.
It's Terraria at the minute.
Sam's pointed out that the arms are in sync with the legs. Yeah, that's something that you wanna don't. You don't wanna do that. I don't know, really. I'll have a look at it, see if it looks bad. just concentrating on doing the legs at the minute. Yeah, it is. No, wait. Yeah, he's. Yeah, you can see, like, no one walks like that. You usually use your arms to counter your. That's the thing, though, with this, it's, his arms. His body is still. Dominated by his leg movement, so you have to kind of think about that as well. And I wanted his arms to be attached to it at the back of his scales. So what I'll do is cut this and put it here. Cut that. Oh, what's going on here? That there. Let's see how that looks. I don't know if this is going to look right, actually. I'll see what it looks like. Nah, it looks like he's just. Let's have a look. That doesn't look right. So, yeah, I'm going to just have to draw the arms in manually. That's not working. Okay. I think there's only one of the arms at the back. It's sort of. Nah, it looks stupid, really. Actually, that's all that. Ah, right, yeah, I can see where the big problem is. You can see that on this one here. His body's, he's doing the same thing, really. He's kind of just moving the same Terraria style. But yeah, you can see that, his body's actually sort of looks like it's twisting more, whereas this is not happening here. I'm just wondering whether to actually count the weight shift. I don't know if it's gonna work really, just because of the way the whole body moves. I'll try it manually, see how it looks. Just draw each frame in. It's literally just a few lines. So it's not a big thing. I'll fix that as well while I'm at it. Sort this body out. Alright, what's happened here? Alright, I haven't actually done. An in between part for that body. You know, it's been a while since I've animated an enemy, so I've forgotten to do a few things. I'm gonna just get this sorted first then. So really, what I want to do is I want to basically give this body part here the illusion of rotation, really, and you can do that with just a simple two-frame animation. I've been using that for most of the armors and the helmets, and it looks fine. It actually gives a good feel of rotation without having to actually manually draw each piece. You just need a, it only works with things like consistent patterns though, so you do need to bear that in mind. Right, what I'll do is I'll just draw each in between of these dots here. So these are just to show like scales. And it's just a simple, just simple dots really, because really the scales just, you know, if you're gonna do simple art like this, this is all you'd need. As any animator who's been animating for a while knows, just how long it takes to animate something. You just want to make sure it's as easy as it can be for the job it needs to do, really. So, in terms of game art, animation tends to be, or back in the day when it was, you know, Mega Drive games, and that's Genesis to any Americans. Or back in the times of Super Nintendo, you'll notice that a lot of the animations are just simple extreme frames done well. And there isn't really actually much smoothness in the animation, so you can get away with, especially like on the scale that these enemies will be, they're just on such a small scale that you're not really gonna notice. You can just be, as long as you can be pretty economical with how many frames you use, and be very efficient. But you know, some people go for a more smooth looking thing. I know our characters are pretty smooth with the way they attack. Just because, like, we don't like games where it's a one frame attack. When you need control over your attack, it's just, it's better if it's smoother, in my opinion, at least. I'm just wondering whether to just copy those lines. Yeah, I think I'll just copy them and fill out the blanks. This is the thing, really. If you go totally freestyle, it's like you can go totally freestyle with animation, and it's just going one frame after the next, and it can look really good and smooth. But sometimes you do it that way, and you will tend to It'll slowly start to morph your actual the thing that you're trying to animate. That's something I noticed. I don't know if anyone sort of if anyone used to if anyone who's watching this used to follow the Flash movies back in the day. There was a popular stickman animation called Zio Zio. His animations tend his stick figures tend they did tend to shrink to tiny sizes, and it made me wonder if he, you know, if he ever referenced back. I mean, it makes me wonder if he did, just because I don't think he'd need to with a stick man. It's pretty easy to remember, so. But yeah, that sort of thing can happen. The thing that you start drawing just totally changes in appearance. That's another reason as well. People use character sheets a lot. A lot of animators, you'll find that popular cartoons, they use like character sheets, and that's one of the reasons why they use them. Well, you know, the structure really, to reference back to that structure, how it should look and things like that. Let's see how that looks. If I need to. He doesn't look too happy about it, does he? You forgot about it, nice. Why are you drawing me all crappy? I'll fix this thought. Just want to keep the shape here. That's why I'm being a bit. There's probably a quicker way around doing this, but. You just learn a program, you always learn about a thousand ways to eventually, when you've used a program as long as I've used this, you'll find there's a million ways to do one thing, so. Right, yeah. Doesn't look as good as I thought it would. I think the main reason is it's just not in position. So I'll just try moving it over a bit. Yeah, it needs to be further down. That. Yeah, you can see the actual scales as well. They're a totally different thickness, so I'm gonna have to fix that. It's another bit more
A bit chunkier. What's happening here? That shouldn't be happening. For some reason it's not. What's happening here? Oh yeah, that's why, because I'm painting behind it. Might be why. So yeah, I just want to make these chunkier. Go a bit bigger as well with the paintbrush. Let's do the scales like, you know, like a brick wall. It'd be like, one in the middle, like triangles, so it would make diagonal straight lines if you connected the dots, and it's like one, one, two, one, one, two. And that's how a lot of nature's animals have the scaled patterns. They'll just be like a similar to how roof tiles would be. Just one of those observations that you gain over observing things from a certain amount, you know, after a certain point. The patterns of life will come. That looks like it's in the same place, really, if I'm being honest. It just looks like it's the same thing, that. I don't know what I've done wrong there. That's just totally failed. I'm gonna have to do it again. I shouldn't have been hard to do. I don't know why I've done that wrong, but I'm gonna have to do it again, I'm afraid. You know what? I'm gonna select the whole damn thing. Just then. And then put this frame over it. Oh, thanks. Alright. Don't think I did this before, so at least I'll have the body part to reference from. That's still not right. That will do. Alright, let's try that again. Alright, grab the colour. That should be a bit lighter. Let's draw in between each thing again. I'll make sure it's actually chunky enough, bear all this in mind. As well, like, you know, this is well worth doing. I know it looks like a pain at the minute, but it will look right. It'll look like a loop. It'll look like it's been drawn in 8 directions, whereas it's just a simple pattern and it hasn't. So it's worth doing. It's like things like this, really, that it's like animating for games. It's just something I've noticed. It's the sort of thing you tend to do more. You do more of this sort of thing, really. I'm not sure if I would do this if I was animating a cartoon. It's just something more like a... Then again, I wouldn't even... you know, the perspective of things and all that stuff is totally different as well. Have I just done the... I'm just not paying attention here. I'm just going to concentrate on making sure that each dot is actually horizontally in between from point to point, because that's more important than the scale pattern. Because it just doesn't look like it's joining up as a scale pattern for whatever reason. I don't know. Maybe I've just not done the actual scale pattern part that well, but... I'm gonna see how that looks anyway. Before taking it any further. Okay, that's better. Right, that should look fine. So you can see, like, it looks like it's, if I do it fast enough, it looks like it's spinning around. It probably won't look so much like it now, but it will. It just needs like a, it just needs like the actual things like this, the head here rotating around to accommodate it, and it will look right. Once again, I'm going to copy these. Just gonna no. What's going on? Hey, then it looks like Flash is throwing a wobbler. It's fine now. Yeah, save often. Golden rule of Flash is save as much as you can. The amount of frames of animation that Sam and myself have probably lost due to learning that rule, or not knowing the rule, it's probably, I don't want to think about it. We've lost scenes of work. So, don't learn it the hard way. Save. Make a habit of it. Doesn't matter how good your computer is. I suppose that's one plus of the traditional animators on pencil, is they didn't have to save. But then again, you know, at the same time, it only takes someone to spill the coffee or whatever on the work. Speaking of caffeine, Sam, don't know if you're too busy or anything, but all this talking, getting a dry mouth, you see. I've just noticed Sam's obviously overwhelmed in emotion with my patterns of life philosophy. What can I say? It just comes. The patterns, that's going to be my, it's going to be my book. If I do a book on, how to draw. Call it The Patterns of Life. Okay, so yeah, that's looking a lot better now. Right, so I just need to put this in every diagonal frame. And, oh, that's two parts, isn't it? Copy all that, bring it over, paste there, delete the head, boom, 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 boom. Since I'll be exporting this as an image later, it doesn't really matter how much much data it takes up on Flash, except for the fact that, you know, it'll slow the actual program down. I generally try and keep my files small in Flash to prevent it from just to optimize computer performance and just keep the workflow going. Even if you're doing like a project Flash, if you were just going to do an actual Flash cartoon, I would recommend keeping each scene separate and just putting the actual cartoon together on a video editor or something based on my sort of experience with Flash. It just doesn't like big files. It can't handle. I just think it's meant to be used for optimal. It's for web mostly. I don't think it's designed as an actual high quality animation tool for films and things like that. I just prefer to separate the files into separate small just scatter the files into smaller file sizes, so Okay, so now we've got each, that should look fine now. Yeah, you can see it looks like it's turning around. And that's four times the size as well, so you know, you're just not going to notice. Looks like it's just spinning around. I mean, normally I just do the five frames and you can just pick the three and flip them around, but because of this fish's face, it's not symmetrical like that skeleton's face is up there, for instance, so I'm gonna have to pay for that silly face there, but I do want that face. I'm willing to pay the price and just draw the face in each direction. Okay, so yeah, that looks fine. So, right, I just need to grab. In fact, I'll grab that one. Press the wrong button. I'm gonna get rid of that. As lovely as that background is, Sam, it's distracting me from the actual animation. So I'm just gonna turn it off for now. I'll put it on at the end. So now we're just going back to the side animation. So I can just paste that over the top again. Just remembering to do all these things, really. Yeah, like, I think it's just not used to really talking and doing it at the same time, so not the best multitasker, but if you're actually concentrating, you can just learn all these little things that'll just speed up the workflow. Just like remembering to do logical things, like at the end when you've positioned that frame, say you wanted it there in this frame, you could just copy, paste, and paste that, and do this thing called paste in place on Flash, which is it just pastes the object in the exact same place as where it was. So you know, you could do it. It would work perfectly for this sort of thing. You don't have to spend time having to align it. Just wondering whether to. No, I'm gonna keep that. Oh, I've just done that. Yeah, screw it. I'll leave it like that. Yeah, that looks alright. Okay, I'm gonna draw a separate layer for the hands in this one. So his legs are going that way, so I need his arms to come this way, really. I think they'd be lower than that, to be honest. They'd be like there. And then this one would be balancing that. Like, it's like the opposite leg kind of counterbalances. If you look at how someone naturally walks, their hands will counterbalance the legs. And that looks not too bad. It's probably a bit too much, actually. About there. You don't want to look... It's going to look like a power walk, this. This one probably be curving. So he's got like flat fish hands. So you just want to show that really in the actual. I'm going to do that here. There's like the idea that they're just kind of curved,
twisting. Like the little pieces of. I'm not sure that looks right actually. Okay, let's have a look.
Right, so that arm would come to about the middle there. Front part. And I think that back end would start to twist out there. That's too much, isn't it?
Just too much, right?
That would probably come to about there, yeah. And then that would probably twist there.
And then we're gonna get rid of that. Okay, so.
The sort of outside of his arm is sort of the predominant moving part here. So I'm just going to put that to the.
Follow that. Now you can see that looks alright there.
So. So he would be dragging that arm. I could probably even twist that up a bit more. So it looks like he's twisting his actual hand part. See there, he's twisting it. Probably flicking it too much there. Lower it a bit. There we have it. Okay. I don't think you'd even see any more of that other hand than that. Like that would probably cover it. Let's see how that looks coloured in. So I'll just start closing the gap. Looks fine. feel the time is right to plug the green light again. Or I don't know if I've actually done that yet, but it's certainly in the title.
But if you like the idea of creating scripts and you want to show support,
you can by greenlighting us
or telling your friends about it, something like that, just spreading the word. It's always appreciated.
And I'll thank you in advance.
I'm also considering doing more streams in the future, and perhaps giving green light voters a chance to have a weapon designed. I'll probably just pick a weapon from a pile of suggestions from green lighters and just sort of finding the best. It's, you know, my favourite suggestion, or maybe even picking one at random. And I'll just put the weapon in game. So yeah, I mean, if anyone's sort of interested in that idea, you know, you can be sure to just suggest something on the green light. And if I get enough people doing it, then I will do that. I'll, you know, I'll start picking suggestions, and I'll probably do a stream of that as well. So yeah, back to this anyway. Let's have a look. Right, yeah, you can see he's pretty much dominated by his head moving about there, really. So it's just, it isn't going to look that powerful the way he walks with his hands, but... And on the other hand, you've got this one here, which is a lot more rigid looking. It's quite, oh, that's not even, this one, sorry. Where he would just be, it's kind of a bit twisting, really. He's not even moving his arms really there, he's just kind of twisting. I think I'm just going to go for this one though. Yeah, I'm liking it really. I think it's nice. So... Sorry, I'm going to hide the weapon there. In fact, I'm going to hide the weapon in while I'm doing this. I'll do the weapon last, because it'll be quicker. So, that, I think I'll just draw the arms in again, but this time it shouldn't be as bad because I can just do some flip rotating and such. I'll show you what I mean. Because I'm gonna do it again anyway. If I don't need that, that's fine. You know, these can be the centerpieces. Don't know why. Yeah, these are fine. I just need to draw the actual one frame here, and that's one arm going back. That. How does that look? That doesn't look right. So this arm would be back in a little bit. And if that was twisting, then you'd have that flatter, I'd imagine. Oops, even showing like a curved, like a celery shape. Show his flatness of his hand. Let's have a look at that. Is that too subtle? No, I think it's about right, that actually. But it just needs to be moved. Oh no. What frame is this being drawn on? The wrong bloody frame. Yeah, check your frames, don't do that. That's why I've done it, because I need that reference. So, that would be going back. And then you'd have this one here, probably about that sort of look. Try it a bit there. Twist it. Probably too much, but it's the sort of thing you want. Yeah, that's alright. Actually, I'm gonna just get rid of most of that. Just leave it like that, I think. Is that too much? I think that is just too much, really. I'm gonna just keep it thin. Yeah, that looks better, really. It's twisting just too much, really. Because when the arms are sort of going back, they don't really move back much, they just... It's like when they're moving frontwards, really, that's when you see the most arm movement. Especially considering, you've got to consider his head governing his arm direction and positions and such. I'm not sure that looks right. Keep it in this position. Alright, let's get the other arm in anyway. So the other one is top, the sort of outline of it was the I was at the inside, let's have a look. Yeah, you can see the outline there is the thing that's moving. Like the outside of his arm there. So, let's just make sure we do that. So here, we want that to be in more. And then this back bit here, it's probably just gonna be twisting like that. And then perhaps his arm will be slightly raised up there, his hand, or the edge of his flipper. Fin. Fin, it's not a flipper, is it? It's a fin. Right. That is extreme. It's too much at the top, really. So I'm just gonna smooth it out at the top more. Okay, that's looking. Yeah, it's still a bit extreme, really. You can see it now. I'm gonna just totally. I'm gonna just totally redo that bit of the arm. Okay, so we'll probably put it to the. So it's just moving forward rather than totally twisting around, which is what it's doing on the other arm, really a bit. So. Should put some under the sea on or something to just fill in the blanks when I'm quiet. Just a tutorial to under the sea. Speaking of sea, that's making all this talk of water, it's making me thirsty. Some. Yeah, that's alright. I see. That's twisting it a bit. It's countering his leg. You can see that. Kicking it in. And he's flipping his other arm instead. Need to put the green in. This will do flipping it as well, so I'll show you what I mean. Right, so let's get the stripes in. Those are scales, by the way. Just on it, they're at such a small level you can't see them, I'm afraid. They're just lines, so don't tell anybody. So you can see. This arm would probably be barely showing. It'd just be thinning out really there. And you can see where I've done this, made it a bit lighter there because I wanted it to look like it was fanning toward you a bit. So that would just not be, they'd probably be in this bit, and that's it really there. So that's it, that's the coloured flippers, or fins, not flippers. Don't know why I'm calling them flippers. So you can just use this again for this side, and in theory should look fine. There you go. It's just strutting around. So you've got this a strutting fish. King of the ocean, that is a king of the ocean walk. It's still very, very subtle and I don't know why that frame's missing something there, but it probably needs a little more arm movement somewhere, that. But you can get, if once you've got the side and the downwards facing animation, you pretty much, you know, you can use these as reference to the other animations, and you can say, oh, what did I do there? How did I do that? And it just makes it a lot quicker when you're doing the rest of it. It's just getting the actual layout, you know, you're kind of setting the foundations at this point still, so. And there's always a little something that's different about, especially if you're gonna try to draw imaginative characters, like you're not just drawing arms, typical humanoid arms, you're just trying to do something a bit more like it. Well, like this is just, it's just a flat arm really, and you know, you want to just experiment with how that would work really. So you gotta learn things, you just do everything, you know, everything is always different the way I animate it. So right, that one's missing a frame. I'm gonna see if this will
work for this. Yeah, that looks fine. Again, though, you know, I could make that even better, really, just because of its nature, like as a floppy looking object, it wouldn't move back the way an arm would. It would kind of be more circular movement rather than just back and forth. So like this part here, I'm gonna show you. That part is going back to the from here. So what I can do, I can just bring this frame over here. Flash tab in a moment. Save. So you could see that point there. I want to get in between this edge and that edge, because that is the sort of the point of that's the kind of the point that has the power, really. That's where it is. That's the way I've drawn it. So it's about here. For the help of had the right tool. Yep. About there, and then that would be there. Yep, and you can see it's not any different yet. If it is going to be different, you know. Look at that. That's not right. There is some circular motion, just not getting here. And it's just not coming through. I think it's just the way that frame is from there. Yeah, that would.
I'm just gonna leave it as that for now. Because I don't think it's gonna be, it's not big enough to actually. It's not gonna be worth it. It's just confusing me at the moment. But yeah, that looks alright anyway. So I'll just show you that. So you've got that frame here, and then this one, I don't know, it's just something. Still not right about that one. And it might just be the actual, the amount of movement in there that's just lacking. I'll try it, see how it looks. With a bit more movement in the actual, in the arms. It just looks like his arms are backwards, doesn't it? I'm going to do some distorting. Great tool, this. Just helps you with the perspective a lot more. You can play with things, even if like you don't, even if like it doesn't compromise the line quality, but you can sort of understand where you're going wrong a bit more sometimes. So it's good for those purposes, really. Now I would just say it's these frames now that are just kind of probably, it's not accommodating them now. The frames in the middle, so I'm gonna just neaten that up a touch. I've been animating for a while. I know my way around Flash and things like that, but you know, I'm not the best animator in the world. But you know, I've just got a few tips. You know, there might be people who are just starting out, they don't really know where to start with games, and you know, animation, anything like that, how to draw things and things like how things like designing your character first, using a character sheet, having reference to everything, always going back checking, and just keeping the sizes structure consistent. Just these little things that you don't realise when you first start animating. That's the sort of thing that I wish I'd have sort of had when I was doing animation more, but it just wasn't. the internet wasn't like it is today. It wasn't full of YouTube videos. It didn't even exist when I started. So now it's just, you know, if you want to look something up, someone's just willing to show it. And that's the best thing about the internet, I think. One of the best things, just people are just willing to sort of show you how they do things. That's looking a lot better now. Just a bit more swaying. I think that's all it needed. Let me just have a look at that. Something's not right. I think it's just,
like that frame there. Let's get it to the actual M more. Let's have a look at that. So that could probably do with being rotated a bit. Oh, it just doesn't look right.
It's just one of those things. Something's gone wrong somewhere. I wonder if it's the colour, you know. If that's too much. That millions of miles up there. Just don't understand Flash sometimes. Alright, I'm just gonna colour these darker and I might be able to see it better. Because they're in the back, well, that's too green really, it needs more blue in it. Just all these little nitpicky things you do. People don't realize. I don't think it's like, for instance, I don't think I know is this Harry Partridge? I think he's and Orny, popular YouTube animators have said they're not doing the videos as much now just because they can't keep up with the demand, and I don't blame them, to be honest. I think they did a bloody lot considering how long it actually takes to do animation and the quality they come up with and all that stuff. They were just, you know, they just ain't getting enough for what they're doing. No way. And you just get people who can post videos that are just about news and really, and it's just about people talking, and they can't, you know, there isn't much to that. There just isn't as much work involved. And, you know, these people are getting just as many views. How can someone like How can animators make a living and keep up with the sort of demand? There's just no way it can be done. Anyway, I digress. That's a whole nother kettle of fish, that is. Point is, animation is a lot of work. Which is probably why you don't see a lot of it. Not too much. But you know, there are people that are talented in it, but they just don't pursue it because it really is a lot of work. And you could, you know, why do 8 directions when you can just do one direction in 3D? Things like that, really. And there's just a charm about 2D animation that you just can't get in 3D, really. Is that right? Let's have a look. Alright, I'm going to just come away from this for a second. I think I need to just have a cup of tea and come back to it. Alright, so I will leave you with the preview of it. And you can get into leave you with that. You can listen to this. The human world is a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. Seaweeds don't wait greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Under the sea. Under the sea, darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me.
up on the shore, they work all day. How till the sun is laid away? What is the body put on you?
Yes, you go beyond the tree.
Oh no, under the sea. Under the sea. Nobody beat us, fry us, and eat us in fricassee. We want the land for slugs to cook. Under the sea, we have the hook. We got no trouble. Like we see bubbles under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Seems like this video, we got the video naturally.
Naturally.
The chop, the bass, play the brass, the chop, play the top. The flute is the duke of soul. The real geek, the play the lips on the stage. The chop, the blackfish, the sing, the belt and the strut. They know where it's at, they know that blow. Thank you.
Hello, I'm back, and this will be part two of the Creighton's Crypt art channel. Today's episode is animating the fishman, and as you can see, this is what I've done so far. Sam has provided me with the background, which he's been working on the assets for the level. And right now I'm going to get back to drawing the front walk animation, which isn't quite looking right. It's something to do with the swing of the arms, I think it might just be a case of drawing a different looking arm, and not just having two flat arms here. So let's get started on that. Yeah, I think that is definitely what I'm going to do is just delete this. Alright. I'll try. There we are. So, now we're just left with come on. When you're using a Wacom, it's all good and well, but when you come to doing these onions, skins, can get problems. So, really, I want to show this point here as the most predominant point. And, as you can see, it's I want to show that it's yeah, that's too much again. I'll tell you what, I've made this hard. I should probably just left it rigid Terraria style. It didn't look too bad. Never mind. What it is. Yeah, that's looking. Looking about right, really. Let's try that out. Just a thin arm here. Oh boy. What's going on here? It's like his arm's twisting around too much.
I think it's just this back. It's just not right. These arms should be kind of not really. Should be kind of looking like it's going in. I don't think it's really showing that. That's all. Winding me up this. Can't get it right. Should probably use the zoom more. Yeah, I've not really used I've not really been optimal with the use of that. Just the zoom, because you're just gonna get better quality lines when you zoom out. Oh dear, I just don't know what's going wrong here. It doesn't look too bad on that side there, but it's like it's going in, out, and back. It should look. I don't know what's going wrong with it.
Actually, just the way his head's twisting, it should be just. His arms shouldn't be really showing up that much. Perhaps that's what it is. You know, maybe I'm showing too much arm at this point. The joys of animation. Like it's too much, really.
just looks silly. See, the side one looks fine, but I can't really grasp why the hell this flipper here, or the fin, is just not looking right. And I might have just been better off keeping the the fins that I had, and then just